And it brought it in? What? Shut the front door. I didn't have to do that. I hope that came through. That's cool. That's cool. I actually hope the functionality that Gling has, I hope that Apple would just buy them out and just take what they built. For them to put it into Final Cut Pro. If DaVinci gets it, I'm fine with that too. Just as long as that function, I love using Gling. And if you haven't heard about it, it's Gling.AI. It removes all your silences, the bad takes. So if you say something multiple times, it will remove it automatically. And then it exports an XML directly to DaVinci Resolve, Final Cut Pro, and Premiere Pro. It can do multicam clip to Final Cut Pro and DaVinci Resolve. It's just a great tool, especially if you're making scripted YouTube videos that you do multiple takes to say the same thing. It blasts through a lot of that. The transcriptions are really good. It's a great little tool. There's a free version of it where you can do 2 hours worth of transcriptions a month for free. So it transcribes the entire video. And I'm gonna show cuts here. So the timeline down here, all the things that were cut out that were just false starts, bad takes. So this was the entire video. It's like, okay, I'm just checking and it just goes on. And I went through, because I usually do the intro multiple times. So I got rid of the all the bad takes. I didn't like the way it sounded. And then there's a take I liked and it finds it. And then it's like, oh, maybe I wanted to keep this in here and you just unclick it. Or if I wanted to keep this line in, you can just select that. And it removes all the bad takes. And they've added a new feature where you can, if you don't want to bring it, like, so if you want to export it, you can export it to a video, just the audio. It'll give you the subtitles that you can put on your video. You can go to Adobe Premiere, you can go to Final Cut, Final Cut Multicam. So if you want, so if you're doing a video like this where you're doing a screen capture or you're doing tutorial, it'll capture you'll have your camera, your main camera, and then you'll have the screen. And you can then separate them into Final Cut Pro or DaVinci Resolve as a multicam, and you can cut between them or you can do something that looks like this. But I think recently they've added where, so I'm also sharing my framework for making videos. And I think, yeah, so they added B-roll. So now this tool will allow you to add B-roll. Maybe that wasn't the best example. And it's coming from Pexels. So these are free and you could just add it. And they've added a little timeline. So now if you're to play that back. You can start building into, oh, I can delete that, there you go. I haven't even used it. Like, literally it was this past week that they added this in. So let's try this one. I like being behind the scenes. Let's see, add B-roll. Oh, so it's not choosing that word. There you go. You can just search for what you want. Yeah, again, I haven't used this feature, but it's definitely pretty cool. I don't know what would happen if I exported it. So let's add that. Let's see what happens if we export. Let's just right now. Why not? Okay, I'm going to export this to a multicam. I don't think it's going to bring it in. I've not used this at all. I don't want to replace that. If you guys are planning on starting a YouTube channel and you haven't, there's a link in the description for where to start. So go check that out if you haven't checked that out. Okay. Let's go back to here. I'm just going to open up Final Cut and see what comes in. There you go. Look at that happy guy. So I'm going to import that XML. Let's see if it brought in that clip. I doubt it would because I would probably need to download it. But would it leave a space for it? Let's see. It did. And it brought it in. Shut the front door. Shut the front door. What? I didn't have to do that. I did not have to do that. I brought it in. I hope that came through. I That's cool. That's cool. That's cool. That is cool. All right, I'm going to make a video about that because, like, damn, that's cool. I love Time Bolt. It was fantastic. It did all those things for me. Ever since I found Gling, I haven't opened it because it doesn't do all the things that Gling does really, really well. It's, Time Bolt is fantastic. If you're using it, keep using it because it's fantastic. Gling just does everything that I needed to do, and now it's doing even more. It's finding free B-roll from Pexels and, like, just based on a search. And it imports it into Final Cut. Like, that's cool. That's cool. Yeah, check it out. There's a way to use it for free, so check it out. See if it works for you. But it definitely works on stuff that is like tutorials or instructional or stuff that it uses scripts. Like, for instance, where is it? Like, not only that, like, if you wanted to just export your video right from here, you can do that. It allows you to do smart captions. Like, you can add captions right to it. You can do jump ins, jumps out. You can do noise removal. And you can do title generator, chapters generator. So if you do a title generator, it helps with, like, oh, so for this video, like, over 40, here's why you need to start your video channel now. Or it's like, okay, that's just being curious. But then you can make it 100% transparent. So it goes through your transcript and it's basing it. So start your YouTube channel over 40, a guide. But then you can also crank it up and go make it super extra clickbaity. How starting a YouTube channel over 40 can unlock new opportunities, or why starting a YouTube channel over 40 could be a great idea. Discover why over 40 is a great time to start a YouTube channel. I like that. I think I'm actually going to use that. Clickbaity, why not? The video is getting crushed because I didn't send it to my subscribers because I thought, hey, I'm going to try something new. But yeah, if you guys haven't started a YouTube channel, definitely check out that video. So that's one thing. You can do a subscribe animation. That's interesting. I didn't see that before. So let's say I wanted to do captions for this. I can just add captions. And then you have a whole bunch of different styles that you can choose, and it should animate it. I don't think it will animate in Final Cut. Fuck, now I need to test this out to see if it'll actually do it. Let's see. Oh, maybe it does. Okay, now I need to know. Is it going to do is it going to bring in that animation? So let's just do two, bam. Final Cut. Let's see what we see. Let's see what happens when we import this. So we're going to import. If this comes in with animated text, well, it brought it in and it's there. It doesn't do the animated part. Which is fine, it's still pretty good because I can bulk change this to something else. Anyways, still pretty cool, Like, this is what Final Cut should have had, you know, with Final Cut 11, but it's not even there yet. So, whatever. If I wanted to, this could be the workflow, is do the whole edit here, have everything kind of banged out, finish that video. Like, say I'm doing a 9x16, it's for socials. I can finish the video, color correct it, do all the stuff I want to do, and then bring it back in here. It'll transcribe it, and then I can just put in the animation. So if you need that, there it is. So, like, you can do it. You can scale it down, make it wider. Still, pretty cool. Pretty effing cool. Yeah, Gling is fantastic. I've been raving about them the moment. When I found them, I was surprised nobody was talking about it, because it literally became the closest thing that I've been able to find to an assistant editor. That's what Gling has done for me. Like, it's awesome. And with my course, it cut through 90% of the bad takes, the junk, and just allowed me to create 10 hours worth of content very, very quickly. Because I just did screen capture, I recorded the camera and the screen capture, and then I was able to put it into a multicam, but it was already edited for me, 90% of it. Then I just go and finesse it, and 15 minute long videos, just plowing through them. Like, there wasn't a better solution that I would have been able to do. Like, trying to go through it and delete the ums and the ahs and the bad takes. I literally went from hours a day to make one of these videos to like under 2 hours. I was able to get them out, rewatch it, and just have a video ready to go. And that's why I feel very confident that these updates for my course are going to get done very quickly, because I have a workflow that works. And that's what it's about. Find processes that work for you. Some people don't like processes. I love them. There are times where it looks like I'm not doing anything, and then all of a sudden, bam, everything's done, because it's all been kind of processing in the back of my head. 50% off my course for my Final Cut Masterclass. I'm doing a whole update on it. 50% off. Use the code CyberCut to get 50% off the course, which I'm going to be updating to all the new cool stuff that Final Cut has to offer.